Welcome to another Code Partners component video. Today we will be looking at Employee Paystub Web Self-Service, which is basically a web-based tool that allows employees to access historical pay stubs from a secure site. In this example, we're using U.S. payroll. This application will work with Canadian payroll as well, though. So to begin, we're going to go and look up an employee number. For this example, we're using Dale Smith. If you look at the other tab, you'll notice this 246 in line 4 of the alternate address. Really what this is for this application is password storage. So Dale's password is 246, and this will come into play a little bit later on in the demonstration, but I did want to point that out to begin with. So remembering this password and the employee number, we'll move on to payroll transactions to calculate our payroll. For this example, let's make it December 20th, 2009. We're going to select all frequencies. And in the example again, our employee number, we're going to punch that in and process. We don't need to print any exceptions reports, so we'll click No and move on to payroll checks. Again, that date that we're using in the example is 12/20/2009. And the bank that we're going to select is this Second National Bank. This is the one we're looking for. And at this point, this should look pretty familiar to you. Here we go. Here's your check. You can see what it looks like. We're going to go ahead and close this out. When we get to this point, this is definitely an important step for us, but we're going to come back to that. We're going to put in one of our new steps right now that'll make this work for your employees. It's Payroll Archive. So once you get to this step, you click on Payroll Archive. And again, the date was 12/20/2009. We click Process, and then we wait for it to process that employee. It pops up and says it was successfully archived. So we click OK, and we can close out of this. Now at this point, this is when we would go back. Yes, they were all printed successfully, and everything gets posted. So we can close out of this, and you're done. But your employees are able to log in using this secure site. Now, the question of security does come up, and this is not just, this is not just saved in a file folder on a server somewhere where any employee could stumble across another employee's pay history. We actually put the physical files into a SQL Server database for security. So as long as the database is securely set up properly, the PDFs of the historical pay stubs are secure. So this is where the employee number 100100 and that password from earlier, remember it was 246, comes into play. Dale would log in here. And when we log in, it confirms that this is Dale Smith's record. So if it pops up John Smith, you realize, whoops, I typed in the wrong thing. But we're safe here. So this is Dale Smith. And from this screen, Dale can come over and change his password, which is automatically updated in that line 4 of the alternate address inside ACPAC for you. But the main thing I want to show you is this payroll stub. This is where it comes and archives all the old pay stubs. This last one being the one that we just did a few minutes ago. It opens in PDF. And here you have it. Dale can look back on his history. And this concludes our demonstration.